orthodox.
My friend, come on, you are smarter than this. Just denounce this cult. Say, I am out of it.
Yeah, so what do I do then?
Say it, and I will tell you what you will do.
I'm out.
I am out. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Guys, did you hear it? I am out. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for sending this gentleman who sent me a message in Skype saying I want to debate you. He was challenging me. By the way, you did not lose. You did not lose, my friend. You did not lose. Hold on. You did not lose. You did win. You did not lose. Don't think you lost. You won.
I'm just asking. I just called to confirm certain things I've been doing.
Yeah, I'm just telling them what you said to me in text before you call me. I want to debate you, right? You know? So, my friend, you're welcome. I'm happy for you. Now, you see, you refuse because all of this doesn't make sense to you and it's stupid. And
it's because I've never heard of these things before. Everyone's been saying good things.
Problem.
Miracles, all sorts of things, you know, and so yeah,
nope.
You know, not telling us about these sort of things, which you know they're in the hadith and you know, old sort of sources.
Yeah.
Which I find it's basically lying.
I understand, but now my friend, you said to me, what you should do best. You should do next, right? Should I tell you what you should do next? Okay, me as a Christian, I believe that me as a person, I have patience to speak to you, even though your mic is giving me a headache, because my Lord, He taught me to love every human being, including the Muslims. God is love, and I advise you to follow the one who teaches you to love everybody, because love can change all mankind, can change you to a different person, can make you happy, can make you healthy. Hate kill you. It's like a poison. You eat it, you are the first one to die with it. So when Jesus, He said, love your enemy, bless them those who curse you, maybe it sounds like, okay, I am being nice to others, but the fact, the first thing I do, I am being healthy. I am being healthy in my heart, I am being healthy in my mind, and I am stress-free. Because when I love everybody around me, I have no stress. Secondly, I'm happy. Number three, I trust myself. Because you know what? I don't have enemy. Yes, they hate me, they want to kill me, but I have no fear. I love everybody. So I say to you, and I invite you in front of everyone, to accept the Lord, the Messiah, as your Savior, who said, love your enemy. The one who resurrected people from the grave. The one who said to the blind, see, and he saw. Not like Allah, who said to Muhammad, read, and he could not read. The one who said to the man, he cannot walk, walk, and the man carry his bed, and he walked. The one who said, for I forgive your sin, but don't do sin again. That is Jesus, my friend. So I invite you to the King of Kings, the one who have the wisdom which nobody have. I invite you to read the Bible from the first chapter of John all the way, the four Gospels. It's amazing. It's so beautiful. And you will never find something better. So I invite you, my friend, to believe in the best of the best. And that is the Messiah, the Christ, my Lord. What do you say?
Well, obviously, first I got to go and read the Bible and, you know, see what it's saying and, you know, look. For the historical Jesus, and you know, just find out things.
No problem, my friend. I wanted from my heart that you will say I believe, but for sure we want you to believe from your heart, but not by your tongue. We are not like Muslim who say Shahada. We don't want you to do that. We want you to be a believer. But again, I remind you that me and you, we might go to sleep now and we never wake up. And salvation is an opportunity. So I invite you for the opportunity of salvation. And you think and you read, and this is why actually I am the one who told you go read. We don't want you to believe it blindly. We want you to have faith based on truth, not
at least I can understand it.
No problem, I understand. And I'm not saying to you, just say I believe. You know, no, I want you to believe. I don't want you to say I believe, but yet you don't believe. But
I'm saying at least I can understand what it's saying compared to the Quran, where you know you just rely on translators, you know, telling the truth of things.
Right. Yeah. And that's why I'm here to help you, my friend. I'm happy that you called me today. I'm happy that you decide to leave Islam. I will be happy if you call me anytime soon and say to me, I decide to accept Jesus.
Yeah, of course, as I embark on this journey, obviously I'm gonna you know, certain questions are gonna come to my mind, and obviously
sure, my friend. Thank you very much for calling me. If you feel you change your mind, you wanna say you accept Jesus, just let me know, and I will be happy to hear it. And everybody here will be happy for you. We have almost 700 people listening, and they will be really happy to hear you that you accept the Messiah. And the Lord, He said, when a lost soul came back to Him, a happiness will be in the kingdom of heaven. Which means the whole heaven will be happy for you for accepting the Messiah. That's why I wanted to invite you, and I believe the Lord using me to speak in my tongue to you, which means the Messiah Himself is speaking.
Right, so what's
to
the process? What's the process? For example, if you read the Bible and so on, and then you know you realize what's the truth, then what do you do from there?
Right. Yeah.
Is it, well, don't you have to say anything, or you know, is there like a formal way?
You see, my friend, you read the Bible, but don't read it as a story. Try, you see, that's what I do since I was a kid. This is why I read differently from what people do. You notice, like me, when I speak to you, I go deep in the words, right? So I analyze the words. So when I read the Bible, I close my eyes and I imagine myself there. Imagine yourself living the story, not hearing a story. So you want to know what Jesus is saying? Live the story, and you will enjoy it. And you will notice that each time you read the same story in the Bible, it fits with something happening to you right now in your life. And no matter how many times I read the Bible, each time I read it, I find something there. Now it's happening to me. Even though the Bible is a book written 2,000 years ago, it's not going to be expired, because the wisdom of Christ is amazing. So you live the story and you will see the Lord, he will speak to you within that story, even though it is mentioned 2,000 years ago for people who have no electricity, who have no TV, they have nothing. I mean, its life is very simple, a cow and donkey and etc.
Yeah, I've heard one thing. Is it true that Jesus prophesied the falling of the temple in Jerusalem, or was the...
Prophesy what?
The falling of the temple.
Yes, yes, yes. He prophesied that the temple would be destroyed, and this would exactly happen. But this is not what made Jesus Jesus. My friend, it's not about Jesus prophesying something and
if I say I'm someone, then I gotta prove it, right?
I know, but I mean, there's tons of things Jesus, he said, they become to be true. But this is not what made Jesus Jesus. Jesus is unique. He's not a prophet only. The only prophet, actually, in the whole universe is God himself. Because a prophet of God, he have nothing of his own. He prophesy what God told him, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, so the real prophet is God. So Jesus is a prophet, but yet he is our Lord. So all the prophecies he said, anything he says is true. Anything he said is going to happen, or it may be happening already. So I am not surprised to see things he said is happening or will happen. But there's more than this. There's things which are amazing beyond imagination. There's something beautiful about him. The Messiah, what? When you believe in him, your life change. You see, you believe in Muhammad, you will notice many, they go, let's say, they go to jail for a month. They meet with some Muslims, they share Shahada, convert to Islam, and second day he come out, you want to do jihad. So Islam changed you to be a violence person, a person who goes for violence. And Jesus, he do the opposite.
It's in chapter 9.
Sorry?
It's stated in chapter 9, which I believe is one of the most violent.
No, the whole Quran is violent. The whole Quran.
Well, the chapter
actually, the Quran does not contain much violence as Muhammad life stories. Muhammad, he cut a woman to pieces.